Hi, I'm Lucinda and I'm a visual effects artist, and I'm excited to show you exactly how I animate and projection map my paintings using Adobe After Effects. This entire process starts with a physical artwork. I take a clean, straight-on photo and even lighting so the proportions match the real canvas. I bring that image into Adobe Lightroom and crop it precisely to their canvas edges. Those edges will become my anchor points later when mapping. Inside After Effects, I import the cropped image and create a composition from it. I set the background to black, and then in projection mapping, black means no light. So anything black reveals the real surface and anything bright becomes the projected light. Next, I break the painting into pieces I want to animate. Using the pen tool, I mask figure 1, figure 2, and 3, and then all the figures together, and then a separate green painted area for later on. Each layer becomes its own layer I can move independently. On the figure layers, I start with glow, VR glow. For projection mapping, the high contrast is essential. Black disappears and white is the brightest light possible. Glow helps separate the figures from the canvas. To reveal each figure, I use CC light wipe. I animate the light wipe center, moving left to right across the figure, and animate the direction to 90 degrees, set the shape to doors, and check color from source. Then once the keyframes are set, apply easy ease for smooth motion. The painting has a pink background and a green foreground, but instead of creating a mask for those layers, we develop two solid layers, a pink solid for the background and a green solid for the foreground. I apply a gradient ramp from black to the color and animate the ramp so the background fades in gradually. And then to add motion, I layer fractal noise on a low contrast setting and animate the evolution to time times 100 in the expression tab. This creates a subtle cloud-like movement behind the figure. To add depth to the revealed figures, I then apply a drop shadow effect. After the light wipe finishes, I animate a slight increase and decrease in distance and softness, and this creates a floating dimensional feel as if the figures are lifting off the canvas. For the vine effect, I use paint bucket. I set the fill color to green, stroke to anti-aliased, and animate the tolerance value up and down. This makes the green fill spread and retract across the figure, mimicking vines or energy growing over the painting. And then between layers, I create transitions using gradient white or smooth soft transitions between new colors or solid. On the separate green mask from the original painting, I add hue and saturation to shift it into a brighter green and then apply turbulent displace. By animating the amount and size, the vines wiggle, stretch, and pulse, creating motion that separates it from the figures. To finish the animation, I switch to the mask of all three figures together and apply CC Mr. Smoothie. This adds a gentle evolving color flow that unifies the piece so it doesn't feel like separate effects. Once the animation is complete, I create a new composition labeled projector and set it to 1920 by 1080, matching my projector's resolution. I select all animation layers then and pre-compose them into a single comp called animation and drag that into the projector comp. I composition and scale it so it roughly aligns with the real canvas on the wall. And then in the video preview, I enable Mercury Transmit and select the display connected to my projector. This sends my After Effects composition directly through the projector for real-time mapping. I then apply a corner pin effect and I pull each corner of the animation to the exact corners of the physical painting. I zoom in and adjust the skew and perspective until the digital shapes sit perfectly on the painting. Then I make final brightness and contrast adjustments so the projected light blends naturally with the paint texture. And here's the finished matte piece, my static painting brought to life with movement, light, and color, all animated and projection mapped inside Adobe After Effects. Thanks for watching, and I hope this helps you create your own projection mapped artwork.